Hello everyone, you're watching PC Helper and welcome to another video in the Python 3.9 tutorial series. If by the end of this video you feel like you have learned something today, then please leave a like and also don't forget to subscribe to PC Helper for regular content. So at the end of the last video, I gave you all some homework. I told you to write a program to find whether a number is prime or composite. So in this video what I'll be doing is, I'll be explaining line by line how this program works or how to make this program. So I want your suggestion on this one first. So whenever I'll be giving you some homework, in the next video I'll be explaining you that program on how it works. So I want to know if you want me to write the program while making the video, or you want me to do it like I'm doing in this video, that I've already written this program and now I'll explain you line by line. So write in the comment section if you want me to write the program while making the video, or if you or should I just explain it like this? I've written this program already and I'll now just line by line explain it. So write in the comment section what you want. So now let's get started with this program. So first of all, we have to know what is actually a prime number. So a prime number is a number which is greater than 1 and it has no divisor except 1 and the number itself. So for example, 3 is greater than 1 and it has no divisor except 1 and the number itself, which is 3. So it is a prime number. And all the natural numbers which are not prime numbers are called composite numbers. So now let's break down this program line by line. So first of all, we named a variable named num and we took input from the user, an integer input as you can see, and we told the user to enter a number. Once the input was taken, we started a if statement, because if a number is greater than 1, then only it is considered to be a prime number. So the first condition was if num is greater than 1. And the else condition for this if statement is, if it is not greater than 1, then else print the number is not a prime number. So it is as simple as that. The first line is we are checking if the number is greater than 1 or not. Now we have to check if there is any divisor of that number except that number and 1. So we have to check starting from 2 and to till the number itself whether there is any divisor in between. So for that we have started a for loop for I in range starting from 2, because we have to check starting from 2 because 1 is divisor to all the numbers, and the range is till the number itself because the number itself is also a divisor of itself. So we have to check till the number itself. So this is the range of our for loop. And to check if a number is a divisor to any number or not, we simply have to check if the remainder of their division is 0 or not. So now in the next line in this for loop, we have written if num modulus I is equals to 0. So modulus is used to check the remainder. So when the number entered by the user is divided by I, if it gives the output equals to 0, if the remainder is equals to 0, then we will print num is not a prime number because it has a divisor in range 2 and num. And now before proceeding further, first of all, let's just execute this program. So now I have executed this program to see how it is working till now. So first of all, because of this first line, it is asking us to enter any input. So let's enter the number 9. And it gives 9 is not a prime number and 3 times 3 is 9 as an output. So let's see how it's working. So first of all, it checked if the number is greater than 1. The number was greater than 1 because the number is 9. Then the loop was started. For the first time when this loop ran, I was equal to 2. And 9 divided by 2 does not give 0 as a remainder. So the loop ran again. For the second time when the loop ran, I was equal to 3. And when this time we checked this condition, 9 divided by 3 gives 0 as a remainder. So it executed the lines of code written inside this if statement. So first of all, it printed num which is equal to 9 is not a prime number. Then it printed I times num divided by I is num. So it printed 3 times 9 divided by 3 is 3 is num is 9. So 3 times 3 is 9. This is what it printed. And then because of this break statement, we came out of the loop and the process was finished. So this was the scenario when the number was not a prime number. But what if the number is a prime number? So then simply let's execute the program again to understand what is happening now. So let's enter a prime number, let's say 5. So this time it printed 5 is a prime number because first time when the loop ran, I was equal to 2, 5 divided by 2 does not give 0 as a remainder. Then second time I was equal to 3, 5 divided by 3 also does not give 0 as a remainder. And same happens for 4, 5 divided by 4 also does not give 0 as a remainder. So when the loop ran for the third time and I was equal to 4, after that the loop ended because the range was only till 5. So the loop will run for 2, 3 and 4 and then the loop will end. And one important thing to note here is that that this if statement is inside the for loop, but the else statement for this if statement is outside the loop. So in this case, when the loop ended, else statement was executed and it printed 5 is a prime number. And now if you're wondering why this else statement is outside the loop, so let's see what happens if the else statement is inside the for loop. So to clear any doubts, let's see what happens. So as you can see now, the else statement is also inside the for loop, and now when we will execute this program and let's enter a prime number, let's say 7. We got 7 is a prime number as an output, but 7 is a prime number was printed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. It happened because every time when the for loop ran and every time when if statement was not satisfied, then else statement was executed and this else statement printed that 7 is a prime number. So even if the number is not a prime number, then let's enter a number, let's say 15. And now when I will enter, you can see 15 is a prime number will be printed first, because when the first time the loop ran for let's say 2, because for the first time when the loop ran, I was equal to 2, the divisor was not equal to 0. So this if statement was not satisfied and else statement was executed. So it printed 15 is a prime number. But the second time when the loop ran, I was equal to 3 and 15 divided by 3 gives 0 as a remainder. So if statement was executed, which printed 15 is not a prime number, 3 times 5 is 15. That is why it is important to put else statement outside the loop and not inside. As simple as that. So this is how you can make a program to check whether a number is a prime number or a composite number. So yeah, it was a really simple program. If you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. If you like this video, then please leave a like and also share it with your friends. And I'll see you guys in the next one.